everyone, and welcome back to Nurses Lecture Room YouTube channel. My name is Mercy Mary, popularly known as a nurse with the difference, and I make learning easy and accessible for students. I actually got a message from two of my students, so I decided to create this video. What is the difference between preterm baby and same baby? How do I write it? How do I go about it? Today we're going to be giving you a lot of differences between preterm babies and full-term babies. But before we go into details, kindly click on the subscribe button, turn on the notification button so you don't miss out. It's going to be interesting. In terms of the difference between preterm and term babies, I actually tabulated them. This first part is the criteria. The other part is for preterm babies, and the last part is for term babies. The first criteria we are going to be using to differentiate them is the gestational age. For preterm baby, it is less than 37 weeks. Why for term baby, it is 37 weeks and above? Then the second criteria is birth weight. For preterm babies, it is less than 2.5 kg. While for term babies, it is more than 2.5 kg. You can get 3 kg, 4 kg. Then in terms of the head, for preterm babies, the skull bones are very, very soft with large frontal nerves and sutures that are wide. You get those things are not, they've not joined together properly. So the frontal nerves, the sutures, they are very wide. But in terms of a term babies, the skull bones, the feet, the sutures, and frontal nerves are not wide apart compared to what a preterm babies. The other one is the posture. For preterm babies, infant lies in a relaxed attitude. The lips are more extended. They lie what? They are relaxed. They are lying relaxed. The limbs are what? More extended. But in terms of a term baby, it rests in a more flexed attitude. You know, this baby is planning to come outside, like a term baby now, flexed, a more flexed attitude. But this one is more extended, it's not mature yet. Then the other one, the muzzle tone. For the muzzle tone of a preterm baby, it is poor. But for a term baby, it is a good muzzle tone. Then the other one is cry. For preterm baby, it is weak or feeble. They don't really cry much. If you even hear yourself, it's God's grace. They don't really cry much. The cry is weak or feeble. Then for term baby, you have lusty cry, a good cry, a loud cry that tells you, oh, this is a term baby. Then in terms of lanugo, for preterm baby, lanugo is plentiful. Lanugo is what? Plentiful. You can see lanugo, the description of lanugo on the screen. Lanugo is plentiful, but in term baby, it is not abundant. Same applies for venous casseosa. Venous what? Casseosa. In preterm baby, it is abundant, but in term baby, it is what? It is less abundant. In terms of the breast, in preterm babies, the areola and nipples are barely visible. But in term babies, the areola, the nipples are developed and they are what? Visible. Then another criteria is the male genitalia. In preterm babies, the testes are undistended. It has what? Has undistended testes and less rugae. But in term babies, it has what? Distended testes. The testes has descended. And it has rugae. The rugae's are what? Plentiful. Then another difference is female genitalia. You know, generally when the female is giving birth to, you see the labia majora covering the labia minora and the clitoris. But in preterm babies, the labia majora is smaller. You see the clitoris and the labia minora popping out more. But in term babies, it is normal. The labia majora covers the clitoris and the labia minora. Then another difference is the fingernails. The fingernails. For preterm babies, nails are soft and short, hardly reaching the fingertips. The nails are short. They hardly reach the fingertips. They are not close to the fingertips. But in term babies, the nails are well formed. They are reaching what? They are reaching the fingertips and they adhere to them. Compared to these ones, where the nails are not reaching the fingertips. Then the last one we have here is the ear. In terms of preterm babies, ear cartilages are poorly developed and may fold easily. The ear cartilages, they are poorly developed, they are not well developed, so they easily fold for preterm babies. But for term babies, the ear cartilages are well formed and they stand erect and return quickly when folded. I think that will help us to get the difference between term babies and preterm babies. If you have any contribution, kindly drop on the question section. Don't forget to share or watch with a friend and don't forget to like. Thank you very much and do have a wonderful day ahead. Bye.